If you are drawing with a pen tablet, it's most likely the size of your pen tablet is either small or medium. Now, recently I switched to a large pen tablet for 6 months, and in this video, I'm going to share my experiences and thoughts. And then you can see if a large pen tablet might be right for you. Recently, I made a video discussing how to pick the right size graphics tablet. I covered both pen tablets and pen displays. The link to that video is in the description. But to quickly recap, for both pen tablets and pen displays, there are four sizes: small, medium, large, and extra large. The extra large tablets are truly gigantic. As far as I know, only Wacom ever made them. The most recent extra large tablet that Wacom made was the Intuos 4 XL. I have this model and I've been using it also for the past 6 months. I'll probably do a separate video to cover extra large graphics tablets. Both small and medium-sized pen tablets are great, but for most people, I recommend that they go with a medium-sized pen tablet, and the reasons for that are in that video. Now, I used a medium-sized pen tablet for many, many years every day, but in January 2022, I switched to a large pen tablet, and my experiences with that large pen tablet are going to be the focus of this video. We're going to be spending a lot of time talking about size. And when we talk about pen tablets, there are two sizes. The device size is the physical dimensions of the pen tablet. Then there is the active area size. The active area is the region of the pen tablet that is sensitive to the EMR pen. With both sizes, we can talk about height and width. However, for the active area, it's very common not to talk about height and width so much, but instead we talk about the diagonal length of the active area given in inches. Let's think about the different kinds of sizes, small, medium, etc., for the Wacom Intuos professional line of pen tablets. Every rectangle shown here reflects the active area size of the latest Wacom pen tablet model that has been released for that size. The pen tablet that I am discussing in this video is the one in the upper right-hand corner. This is the Intuos Pro Large model that was released in 2017. As you can see, it is very expensive. At $500 US, it is the most expensive pen tablet in the market. Though sometimes you can find this model discounted. For example, I have seen it on sale for $400. And as I have mentioned in one of my other videos, there is always the option of buying a pen tablet used and saving a lot of money. Its active area diagonal is about 15 inches. That's very large. Now, 15 may not sound like a lot, but trust me, when you take it out of the box and you hold the full device, it is surprisingly large. Here is an easy way of understanding how big this active area is. The Intuos Pro Large has the same active area as four Intuos Pro Small pen tablets. I purchased this tablet in early January 2022, and my initial reaction was I was amazed. I felt the experience of using this tablet was luxurious. And now toward the end of June, it's about 6 months that I have been using this tablet every day. So let's see what my experience is like now. Well, I am happy to report that I still find it an amazing experience, and I still think it feels luxurious to draw with. There is absolutely no way I would ever go back to a medium-sized tablet. Now keep in mind how I use this tablet. I use this tablet for illustration, and with my style, I draw a lot of long lines. And when I use this tablet, I feel that it helps me have smoother lines and more control. However, with such a large physical size and such a large active area, I did have to adjust how I worked and how I set up my desk. I paid a good amount of money for this larger active area, so I really want to make sure I'm getting the most out of it. Even from the beginning, I did notice that my drawing gestures were starting to get a bit larger. And as they got larger, my lines became smoother, and I felt like I had more control. However, I did notice something very interesting. I saw that I was zooming my drawing application in such a way that I would fall back to my older habits when I had a medium pen tablet. Even for lines that would have easily benefited from using larger gestures, I would fall back to making smaller gestures with my wrist. And there's nothing wrong inherently with using smaller drawing gestures. Lots of styles require them. But when I was doing my style, I just noticed that I wasn't getting the full value of the tablet for those longer lines that I draw. So I really wasn't making the best use of this tablet that I paid a lot of money for. I developed a couple of tactics to help me with this and start drawing with even larger gestures. First, I tried to stay very conscious about using more of my arm and shoulder to draw with instead of just my wrist. Another adjustment I made was with the configuration of my preferred drawing application, which is Clip Studio Paint. I rearranged the palettes on the screen. I shrunk them so that I had more canvas space for drawing. And just seeing that I had this larger canvas space, it seemed to affect my thinking and it reminded me to draw in a larger way. Another thing I did was switch to a larger display. Originally, I started with a 27-inch 4K display, but then I switched to a 32-inch 4K display. And for me, there definitely seems to be some psychological impact of seeing my drawing canvas on this really large physical surface. It helps remind me to draw with larger gestures. So these were the things I tried, and I certainly think they have helped me. But of course, this is specific to who I am and how I draw and my style. Your experience could be very different depending on you and how you like to draw. But you may also need to spend some deliberate time learning how to make the best use of all the extra active area that you have. And that means you may have to put in some work in changing how you draw. Because ultimately, if you are not using this extra active area, then what did you pay for? Now let's dive into the ergonomic issues. In terms of both device size and active area, these tablets are big, and you are very likely going to have to make some form of adjustment on how you set them up on your desk, because I am going to talk about my experiences and my ergonomic issues. There is one thing you need to keep in mind when I tell you about them. I am 6 feet tall, and I have long arms for someone who is 6 feet tall. So when I say I can comfortably reach for something on my desk, many of you may find that it's a little more difficult and a little less comfortable. Another thing to keep in mind is how I set up the mapping between my pen tablet and my displays. I prefer to map my active area on my pen tablet to a single display, even though I have two displays. And I do this because it helps avoid distorted drawing. Let's start by talking about the simple effort required to draw on a large tablet. In my initial experience, in that first week of using the large tablet, yes, I certainly noticed that my hand was moving a larger distance than normal. I did feel it was an extra effort, but I did not find that it was an unusually large amount of effort. And I certainly didn't feel like it was overly tiring. So even with this extra effort, it did not stop me from having longer drawing sessions. And I never had to stop because I felt tired. At worst, I could describe the sensation as merely occasionally distracting. And after a month or so, I didn't notice any of that extra effort. And I didn't even notice my hand making any larger gestures. I didn't feel tired at all. So overall, I would call this a very, very rapid adjustment. Now let's take a look at the physical issues of keeping the tablet on the desk. Again, these are large tablets and they are going to occupy a lot of space on your desktop. Let's take a look at this side-by-side layout. My keyboard is on the left, and notice it is not a large keyboard. It's about 13 inches wide, and I place it just next to my tablet. This arrangement is how I set up my medium pen tablets, and I tried the same setup with my large tablet, which is what you see now. And this layout just did not work for me. If I'm sitting directly in front of the keyboard, I have difficulty reaching the upper right-hand corner of the tablet. I really have to lean over and extend my arm completely. And in general, using the right side of the tablet makes my arm feel uncomfortable, and I have to place it in a rather awkward position. If I'm sitting with a tablet in front of me, then my drawing feels fine, but the keyboard is so far to my left that reaching for it can feel very awkward as well, and I'm having to extend my arm too much. Even sitting directly in the middle between these two devices didn't make it feel easier to use either one. So ultimately, even though this layout works great for me with a medium-sized tablet, it just did not work for me for drawing or typing with a large-sized tablet. So I had to pursue alternatives. This is my layout for drawing. The keyboard is directly above the tablet. It feels very comfortable for drawing, of course, because the tablet is right in front of me. But I still have to reach a little extra for that keyboard. And typing for an extended period of time is kind of unpleasant. I have to really reach out my arms further than I would like. On the right, there's a slight modification to this layout. Sometimes I will pull the keyboard about an inch on top of the tablet. This brings the keyboard closer, but still it does not overlap the active area so I can draw without interference. This change helps, but it isn't that big a difference. For me, it still feels awkward to type on the keyboard. And remember, I have long arms. And it's not just typing. Even pressing shortcut keys is kind of unpleasant in this layout. However, I solved my problem about the awkward position of the keyboard in this layout by getting another device. This is what I got. It's called the Tourbox NEO. It's essentially a programmable keyboard, even though it doesn't look like one at all. These buttons and dials can be mapped to shortcut keys in any application, and it'll even handle the case when you're switching between applications. So if I'm using Photoshop and I press one of the buttons, it'll send a Photoshop shortcut key. But when I switch to Clip Studio Paint, it'll automatically detect that and it'll send a different set of shortcut keys. And I have complete control over what all these buttons and dials do for every application. I really love drawing with this device. It speeds up what I do. I have it configured so that I just leave my left hand on the toolbox, and 95% of the time, maybe even more, as I'm drawing, I never need to touch the keyboard, except when maybe I need to write in a file name or rename a layer. So I've been discussing my drawing setup. For times when I'm doing a lot of writing for an extended period of time, I actually put the keyboard fully on top of the tablet. So this means I'm not using the tablet at all. I'm just using the keyboard and the mouse. Is this ideal? No. But it's the kind of compromise I had to make to deal with such a large device. So if you're going to get a large tablet, you may not do the same things I do. So maybe these layouts may or may not make sense to you, but I want you to know that you should expect that you'll have to do some kind of rearrangement on your desk. Now there's another setup that I have used once or twice, but I prefer not to use it. I keep the keyboard on the upper half of the tablet, and then I configure the Wacom tablet properties and I change the active area so that it is just on the lower half. And then I also map that active area to two monitors. Now this setup can work great because the active area will match the aspect ratio of my two monitors, which is now with two monitors, 32:9. And so I can draw without distortion. And the keyboard is close enough that it feels very natural to type on. This setup essentially gives me the active area of two Wacom Intuos Pro small pen tablets stacked side by side. I've tried it, it works great. However, the reason I don't normally use this setup is because it's not easy to switch back and forth between this setup and my normal setup. And the second reason is, obviously, I'm losing half my active area, and I feel terrible that I paid for the full thing and I'm only using half. But if you are interested in a large pen tablet and you have two monitors, this could be a really interesting configuration for you. So far in this video, I've only been talking about the Wacom Intuos Pro Large. All the topics I've mentioned do apply to other tablets, but now what I want to talk about is what are those other tablets in the large size. Wacom has the model we've discussed. Huion has several tablets in the large size. Some of them are older though, and I do not recommend that you get them at all. If you're thinking about getting a Huion large tablet, then consider getting Huion's latest model, the Inspiroi Giano G930L. It was just recently released in May or June of 2022, and the specs put it right up there with a Wacom. It has a slightly better aspect ratio that will work better with your monitors, and it's less than half the cost. So I think it's a good candidate if you want to save some money. I hear good things about it, and I personally have one, and I like using it a lot. But I just want to make sure you know you have other options there at this size. And now we've reached the conclusion of this video. I want to thank you for your time. I hope you found this video useful.